Most often this question is posed to me by atheists. They say that there are 200 billion galaxies and each galaxy consists of 200 billion stars. They say that God is just a part of this universe. He has not created this universe. They say that they believe in God, but they don't believe that God has created the universe. And sometimes even my mind starts wandering and my heart doesn't believe in that. So please say something on this. And my second question is, on the day of judgment, is this whole universe is going to be destroyed? I mean, it's even the galaxies and stars.
The brother has two questions. The first question is that there are many scientists and many people who do believe in God, but they say that Almighty God hasn't created the universe because the universe consists of billions of galaxies. Each galaxy contains billions of stars. Solar system is part of it. So they believe in God, some of the people, he says, but they don't believe that God created. God is a part of the universe. As far as creation of our universe is concerned, it divided into two types. One is the theory of creation, one is theory of evolution. Two types of system. And then each system has got various subparts. And those who believe in the theory of evolution, that it came by nature and it evolved, and they believe that God has got no role in this. And the other people, they believe they're the creator. You want to call him God, Allah, X, Y, Z, that's fine. But they believe they're the creator. Now you're coming up with a mixture of the two. Your friend, whoever has told, he may not be aware of science, I feel. Because two aspects is there. If you say it is coming by nature, then the existence of God is not required. So either he is this or that, he has the cake or he eats it, you can't have and eat it at the same time. Otherwise, he has less knowledge of science. Or maybe he's a novice in the field of religion or science. So if you analyze the two types of two broad aspects of theory, theory of evolution says everything came by nature. It's there, finished time. And one thing is the theory of creation. Now you are saying that it was there and then God came in. So whenever a person believes in a supernatural power, God, he is ultimate. So when you say God, you can't say he's part of it and he's not responsible for everything. So there's no such a God that I know of, anyone believing that. Demigod, fine. So this person may not be doing religion or may not be aware of science, but even if you agree with him for sake of argument that Almighty God is part, who created that God is the question again. So if you say no, God is part of it, so there can be more than one God. If I agree with this person, everything is evolving, it was there, universe is there, and there is God is part of it. So I'll ask, who created that God? It came by nature. So why only one God? There can be two gods. He'll say yes. Why two gods? There can be a billion gods. He'll say yes. So again, that God becomes a false God. Like a person who's a hero, many people consider him to be God. A person who cures many diseases, many people consider him God. So such type of God, they have got no problem. So then he falls into the theory of evolution again. That means this God, what he's saying is God, actually not true God. God who can be created, God, there are multiple gods. So this God is not a true God or not the Allah which we Muslims believe in. So we say, La ilaha. There is no God. Fine? So again, this person falls in the category of evolution. Do you understand? Though he's saying God, but his definition of God is wrong. The moment you can say God is created, he's not God. According to the Islamic concept of Kul Wallawad, Allah says in the Quran in Surah Ikhlas, chapter number 112, verse number 1 to 4, Kul Wallawad, say he's Allah one and only. So here, if he says he'll have to agree there are hundreds of gods and millions of gods. So again, it is not our Allah which we believe in. Second is Allah Samad, Allah the absolute and eternal. Here he's not absolute and eternal. So again, he's not a true Allah. Lam yalid wa lam yulad, he begets not nor is he begotten. This person may have been born to someone or whatever it is. And walam yakul lahu kufuwan ahad, there's nothing like him. So again, this God we're talking about, brother, is not the God which we believe in. So we say such a God we don't believe in. La ilaha. Now the debate again starts. Whether it's evolution or creation. So for that you can see my videotapes. I've given a talk on Quran and modern science, where I've clarified how to prove the existence of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And if you see my video cassette, is the Quran God's word? I have described in detail how can you prove scientifically the existence of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And how can you prove to an atheist the existence of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala? That's a big talk. So refer to my video cassette, is the Quran God's word? As far as the second part of the question is concerned, that will this creation, the universe, galaxy, will it remain or will it be destroyed? This is the second part of the question. As Allah says in the Quran, in Surah Anbiya, chapter number 21, verse number 104, that we have created this creation and we will create another creation. So whatever is there, heaven and the earth, Allah says He'll roll it up. He'll destroy it. There will be a new creation. How will do it? Allah Alam. Scientists have said black hole and this and that, various theories. Allah Alam. Allah says that this creation that is there will be destroyed and He'll create a new creation. How will that be? Allah Alam. The next life that is there, the hereafter, there is hell and heaven, Jahannam and Jannah. So if you pass this test, as Allah says in the Quran, Surah Mulk, chapter number 16, verse number 2, Allazi khalaqal mauta wal hayata. Allah has created death and life to test which of you is good in deeds. Now depending upon the test, in the next life there will be a day of judgment. And then if you pass the test or get plus points, you go to Jannah, paradise, or to Jahannam, hell. Hope that answers the question. Do any sisters have any questions?
Brother, this